Hello all, welcome to my YouTube channel Double E Lectures. I am Dr. Saurabh Mani Tripathi and the topic of this lecture is direct current machines and overview. Before discussing lots of things about rotating electrical machine, we must understand the meaning of the term electrical machine. An electrical machine is a device that is used to convert either mechanical energy into electrical energy or electrical energy into mechanical energy. And this process is widely termed as electromechanical energy conversion. The electrical machine which converts mechanical energy into electrical one is called generator, and that converts electrical energy into mechanical one is called motor. Unlike transformer, which is a static electrical machine, the motors and generators do have rotating parts. Only transformer is a machine which allows transformation of electrical power only. It is also worth mentioning here that an electrical machine can be operated both as a generator or as a motor, and it is decided by the input to the machine, whether it is being a mechanical input or an electrical input. The working of DC machine can be described by two actions. The first one is generator action, the second one is motor action. The generator action is based on the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. On the other hand, the motor action comes into picture when a current carrying conductor experiences a force upon being placed in the magnetic field. However, before discussing these machine actions in detail, let us first understand the Flemming's left and right hand rules, which are applicable for motor and generator actions respectively. The Flemming's rule describes a definite relationship among the direction of the magnetic field, the direction of the voltage or current, and the direction of motion or force, for which the three fingers, which first finger, the second finger and the thumb, are put mutually perpendicular. Flemming's left hand rule is applicable for motor action. In case of motor action, when the first finger points out towards the direction of the magnetic field, the second finger towards the direction of the current flowing through the conductor, and then the thumb represents the direction of the force exerted on the conductor. On the other hand, for generator action, Flemming's right hand rule is applicable. In case of right hand rule, when first finger points out towards the direction of the magnetic field, the thumb towards the motion of the conductor, then the second finger represents the direction of the induced EMF in the conductor. From the physics of electricity and magnetism, it is well known to all, when the current is flowing through a conductor, a magnetic field around the conductor is created. This is the illustration which shows the direction of the magnetic field around a current carrying conductor. When you hold a current carrying conductor with your right hand, keeping your thumb toward the direction of the flow of current through the conductor, then the remaining fingers points out the direction of the magnetic field around the current carrying conductor. Now, the generator action. As already stated, the generator action is based on the Faraday's law. So, let us understand the Faraday's law of rotating electrical machine. In his experiment, as illustrated in this slide, Faraday found that when relative motion exists between a conductor and a magnetic field, an EMF is induced in the conductor. The word relative motion is much emphasized over here. Since Faraday's law requires relative motion between the conductor and the magnetic field, this means either you may put the magnetic field stationary and move the conductor to get the voltage induced into it, or alternatively, you may put the conductor stationary and move the magnetic field so as to induce a voltage into the conductor. So let us see how a voltage is generated in a single turn armature coil moving into the magnetic field. As can be seen in this figure, at this coil position, the flux linkage to the coil is maximum. However, when the coil is about to turn, the coil sides would slide parallel to the magnetic flux lines, and therefore the coil sides do not cut the magnetic flux lines. So in this position, no EMF is induced in the coil. We may assume the vertical position of the coil as the initial position, naming 0° position. While rotating further from 0 to 90°, the rate of change of flux linkage with the coil plane starts increasing, and hence the induced voltage in the coil. At 90° position, or you may say the horizontal position of the coil plane, the flux linkage with the coil plane is minimum. However, there occurs maximum rate of change of flux. Thus, the induced EMF in the coil is also maximum. Accordingly, in the graph, the voltage waveform assumes its maximum value. For rotation from 90 to 180° position, the flux linkage to the coil plane increases gradually. However, the induced EMF decreases because of gradually decreasing rate of change of flux. Since at position 180°, the rate of change of flux is minimum. So, the voltage now becomes zero in this position also. Similarly, we may see in this figure, when the coil plane position reaches at 270°, once again the voltage induced is maximum, but in this case, we may easily understand that the polarity of the induced voltage would be opposite to that in case of 90° position. When coil further rotates from 270° to 360° position, the induced voltage further decreases to the zero value. As you may see, the coil again reaches to its 0° position. So, this is how a voltage is generated in the coil rotating in a magnetic field. But notice that the current flowing in the external circuit would follow the sinusoidal waveform pattern due to the sinusoidal voltage induced in the coil. So the question is, how the current would be unidirectional or direct current in the external circuit? This can be achieved by replacing the slip rings of the electrical machine with split rings. The split rings are illustrated in this figure. You may notice that it is a conducting cylinder which is cut into two segments with a thin sheet of mica in between. The current in the external circuit is shown here, which is unidirectional, but it must be noted that even if we replace the slip rings with split rings, the voltage generated in the DC generator remains of alternating nature. However, the split rings, which are also called commutators, the current in the external circuit becomes unidirectional. Let us now discuss about the motor action. It is well known to us, when a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, the conductor experiences a force. This is referred to as the principle behind the motor action. Now, the question is, when the current carrying conductor is placed in the magnetic field, what happens then? The answer to this question can be understood by an illustration. So let us see that one. As you may see in the first figure, there are magnetic flux lines from North Pole to the South Pole of the magnets, and a current carrying conductor is placed in this magnetic field. The direction of the current is in upward direction. Now understand the concept. As current in the conductor is in upward direction, we may easily find that the magnetic field due to conductor current is in anticlockwise around the conductor. Now see at one side of the conductor, the magnetic field lines due to both the magnets and the conductor currents are in the same direction, while on the other side, they are in opposition. This way, the magnetic field at one side of the conductor becomes stronger as compared to the other side. And this is why the conductor experiences a force which pushes the conductor into the weaker field. In this case, the direction of the force can also be verified using Flemming's left hand rule. Now see what happens when motor action is there. This is a DC motor where you may see that the sides of the armature coils are represented with the different colors. The conductors are connected to the commutator segments, which are also colored in the same fashion for clear illustrations. Let us assume that the coil plane is in horizontal position. Now you may see the field flux lines are in the direction from north to south poles. The direction of the current flowing through the coil is shown by means of arrows. Now apply Fleming's left hand rule to determine the direction of the force on the conductor. You may realize that the forces exerting on the conductor would be equal but opposite in direction. This results a torque about the motor axis which makes the coil rotate. Particularly in this case, it is in clockwise direction. In vertical coil position, the force on the coil sides are as illustrated in this figure. So, no torque is there. However, because of inertia, when the coil further moves gradually, once again, a torque is experienced by the coil sides. In this figure, you may see that the coil side, which was on the left initially, is now on the right side. And the direction of the current is opposite to that as was initially. However, with the given direction of current, once again, the torque is exerted on the coil sides to move it in the clockwise direction. And in similar fashion, the working continues to rotate the motor coils in the clockwise direction. So this is all about the motor action, which makes the electrical machine to work as a motor for the conversion of the electrical energy into the mechanical energy. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.